Thank you, everyone. Welcome to the Dear Show. And today I'm joined by none other than our very own Dong Nan.
Thank you, dear. Not sure how I got here, but let's get straight to talk about one thing crazier than a reality show, the US election.
Oh, absolutely. The US election is right around the corner. So who's gonna win?
Well, if you ask America's biggest celebrities, both sides are saying the same thing. If the other wins, America's doomed.
Ooh, just like watching two teams in a tug of war. One red, one blue, both pulling real hard.
One side, we've got Trump with a dream team lineup. Elon Musk, Kid Rock, and Hulk Hogan.
Oh, a bit gone for a real tug of war. And on the other side, we have Taylor Swift, Beyonce, and Anne Hathaway.
Wow, and let's not forget Leonardo DiCaprio and even the Avengers assembled for Kamala Harris.
Sorry, Trump. Your team got tech and muscle, but the other side got my heart and soul.
And now that Trump's back on X after his extended timeout and he's playing it so hard, like someone who's finally got his switch back.
And Facebook. Oh, Zuckerberg is doing everything short of wearing a Make Meta Great Again cap.
And TikTok. Trump promised not to ban TikTok if re-elected, trying to lure it towards his side.
Yeah, just one wiry dance challenge away from a full endorsement. Oh, that's where the Trump dance came from!
Yes. But honestly, this election feels less about policy and more like a Hollywood casting call. Since when did running for president turn into an auditioning for the next blockbuster?
Speaking of drama, Trump's out there yelling, "If I don't win, it's rigged." Meanwhile, Kamala's trying to distance herself from Biden.
Oh, the Biden factor. At a Trump rally, a comedian called Puerto Rico the Island of Garbage. Biden fired back, calling Trump supporters garbage, and Trump responded, "My supporters are not garbage," which really helps me understand what is a trash talk.
Honestly, I think Biden might have been taken out of context, as he claimed, but he did use the word supporters. Now I get why my elementary school English teachers stress the importance of singular and plural forms. Apparently, it can save you from calling 250 million Americans garbage.
Well, it's like a soap opera that writes itself. Billionaires are switching sides and voters are just confused.
Right? Look how divided America is. Everyone's choosing sides. Friends, families, the entire state. It's like a Thanksgiving dinner where nobody agrees on how to carve the turkey.
Will Trump finally win or Kamala? Whatever happens, one thing's for sure. The cracks in America are only going deeper.
Absolutely. Thanks for watching, and remember folks, in American politics, if you think you've seen it all, just wait.